I'm lying, I don't run. Anyway, but I do enjoy this. I'm from the East Coast, so I love it when you have a big time zone change, you know what I mean? Got the big space, oh, it makes me feel so exciting. You know, you feel like when you have a big time zone, no one knows who you are. Sometimes I'm a different person. I pretend that I'm a different person. So the last time I came out to the West Coast, I was like, nobody knows me here. I'm gonna be a totally different Debra. So I decided that I would flirt with guys, because you know what? I think I should give it a chance. I'm in my late 30s. This is the chance. Go for it, Debra. Try talking to men. You can do it, all right? Wrong, I can't do it. So what happens is this. I started to flirt with the first like stationary man that I saw. I was like, oh, you're not moving, you're my type, hello. Seriously. Or I think I flirted, I'm not totally sure what I did, to be honest. I tried, I smiled, I tossed my hair a couple times, and then I think I punched him, I don't remember what happened. I panicked, you know, I blacked out for a while. But then I came to in my hotel room, so I thought, wow, that must have went well, that must have gone well, everybody, I'm here. But here's the thing, on a long flight, like 5 hour, 6 hour flight, and this, I'm a human being, all right? So I have to use the bathroom, human. All right. And now the next part of the story, not my fault. All right. The toilet overflowed. All right. Now this is not my fault because I am a delicate rose. All right. That is clearly a faulty toilet. All right. So I've been in the room for 90 seconds maybe. And then I have to phone down to the front desk. I'm like, hi, I overflowed the toilet. Even the girl on the phone was like, what the fuck? You've been there for 5 seconds. I was like, all right, I know. Just send someone. All right. So in my mind, they're going to send like maintenance or like housekeeping or something. But no, at this hotel, they send the cute guy from the front desk that I was trying to flirt with. That is who they sent. That's who they sent to plunge my business. Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah. And not in the sexy way that I had planned either. I'm gonna change the weekend, I'll tell you that. Not good, everybody. But then I'm out here, and so I have some couple friends, and they're like, don't worry, we'll make this better. Debra, don't worry. So they say, we'll take you out after. I'm great, I go out, we have a nice evening. And then one of my friends, is because, you know, West Coast, they have medicinal marijuana, all right? So, and because, you know, he's very sick, my friend. So he... he's very sick. So... We go out together and, you know, he rolls this joint, all right? He rolls this little tiny, like a little pinner, like a skinny one. And I had that moment where I was like, really? This is what you brought? I'm a guest, a little rude. Anyway, I'm gonna say this is it. Whatever, but listen, he doesn't tell me that it's medicinal marijuana, okay? So we smoke this joint. I'm telling you, I had like one drag off of it and I was so high that I had to spend the rest of my night in my hotel room convincing myself I wasn't gonna die. Do you know what I mean? That is it. Your heart's not gonna explode. You're not melting. You're not melting. This is what... And the problem is I overflowed the toilet again. Damn it! Again, I know. Which is what really I consider the second date. I'm not gonna lie to you. You're back. Hi there. Yeah, I can't go back to that hotel. Anyway, I can't.